Praise God, praise God. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. I pray that you're having a blessed day in the Lord. Give him honor. Give him praise, Father God. Father God is good. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm up on here and I'm just going to go ahead and start reading it for you. It says, who are you honoring with your gifts and talents? God or Satan, the devil? Come on, somebody, hallelujah. You know, it's time out for Christians to stop playing this game. I'm reminded about when the enemy took Jesus Christ on a pinnacle and said, if you bow down and worship me, I will give you the glory of this world and the kingdoms thereof. He is doing the same thing to every last one of us. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. Whether you want to say it or not, whether you want to admit it or not, we are living in a world system. So if you are part of the world system, then you already know who you serve. But I'm going to go ahead and walk that thing out. Y'all sitting up there talking about, oh, God bless me, God bless me. God will never bless you in the midst of porn, being a porn star. God is not going to bless you doing anything that is out of his will and out of his scriptures and goes against the laws of God. The devil is a liar. One of the reasons we're not seeing the power of God in the churches is because we keep having fellowship with the enemy through a job, through a relationship, through doing things for money. Hallelujah. God is not going to tell you to steal to pay your bills. God is not going to tell you to sleep with somebody to pay your bills. God is not going to tell you to rob and kill. The devil is a lie. So we're living in a Pharaoh system, a world system. But let me walk this thing out. I got a lot of stuff to read. First of all, praise God. Okay, so Proverbs 18:16 says, a man's gift make it room for him and bring it him before great men. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So my thing is, who's the great man? Is it men of God or is it men of the evil one? All right, so let me go ahead and walk this thing out. I have something that I want to read to you guys. God has given each one of us a unique ability, talents, and gifts. The question is, how do we put them to work? The purpose of gifts and talents. Using our gifts and talents for God's purposes involves discovering your personal vision and understanding your comparative advantage. But it also involves knowing the how and why behind effectively applying these God-given capabilities in every day of our lives. God entrusted us with certain resources. Come on, somebody. Gifts and abilities. Our responsibility is to live by that trust by managing these things well, according to his design and his desire. I just said something. According to his design and his desire. Are you glorifying God with what you're doing? Don't come to me talking about my job. I don't want to hear it. If your job do not glorify the kingdom of God, you got the wrong job. Yeah, I'm saying it like I'm saying. You get mad if you want, because most of you do it anyway. Most of you working for somebody or a company that God didn't even tell you to. But I get it. You bought that money. You need that money. Let me continue. Christians, first of all, we want to go with our design, and our desire says God. Unfortunately, what we do is we work with the idea of our talents. Oh, come on, somebody. And the most of us just want to make money. And God has given you talents to benefit others, not yourself. Your gifts and talents. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Today's popular culture teaches that the ends justify the means, saying, I can do whatever I want in order to get what I want to. Oh, come on, somebody. To have what I want. And yet it says everybody did what was right in his own eyes. And that's in Judges 17:6. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So God is saying that you better count the cost. You sitting up there working a job that God didn't tell you, doing what God didn't tell you. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. He said, don't let that job cause you to go to hell. Don't let nobody cause you to go to hell doing stuff that he never told you to do. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So who are you honoring your gift with? Oh, I'm going somewhere. Preachers, if you really honoring God, then you're going to take care of God's business the right way. You ain't going to be sleeping, creeping, and doing stuff behind God's back. Because let me tell you something. Notice what I said, behind God's back. God watches everything. So you can fool people, but you can't fool God. He said, I neither sleep or slumber. I don't know how y'all think that God is not going to repay you for doing anything that is not of God. Come on, somebody, hallelujah. So I want to ask y'all a question. I want you to really think about it, what I'm saying. Does your life honor God? Does your work honor God? Does your talent honor God? Because if it does not honor God, then you are serving the kingdom of darkness. I don't care. pornos, that's the kingdom of darkness. Anything that pedophile, the kingdom of darkness. Anything with vulgar language. If you on a show, come on somebody, hallelujah. They got my phone going off, y'all, on purpose, and I turned my phone off. You see, do you see that? But I ain't going to let nothing stop me. Come on somebody, hallelujah. Now all of a sudden, so-called Siri want to talk to me. The devil is a lie. Let me tell y'all something right now. Count the cost. When I was in the music industry, this was at a young age. I was driving for Ludacris. That's when he first came out, Ghetto Boys. So I always been in the know. Somehow God had me. And I remember God made me quit that job because, and I'm going here today. I'm going to say some things, and it's real, so I don't care. I would go on drug runs from, you know, buy weed, liquor, and all that. And I wouldn't even save, but I start feeling bad. And God, you know, apparently that was God touching my heart, talking about, you know, you're not right what you're doing. And the money was good. Oh, look, go do this and we give you $500. I'm not kidding. All kind of stuff. And even when I wasn't saved, I knew what I was doing was wrong. But we do things for money. I'm going somewhere. Oh, Lord have mercy. This is a heavy subject this morning. How many times have you lied for money? How many times have you compromised for money? How many times have you said, you know what, I got to do me because I can't go down? I mean, we all have. I'm going here. We all have. Don't lie. But when you come to the knowledge of Christ, you say, you know what, I want to do it the right way. God, I don't understand it. I'm going to do everything in decent and in order. When you